Hi, this is Andrea Earle with your Canvas Tip of the Day number 12, Syncing Canvas Grades with your Aeries Gradebook, updated August 2022. We're going to start by going and setting up your Aeries Gradebook. Mrs. Garcia has graciously allowed me to use her courses to demonstrate for you today. So we're going to start by going to Mass Add Gradebooks. You will notice Mrs. Garcia has all of her courses here, all of the students that are rostered to her. You will notice she's got two sections for period one. That's because at this school, the special ed students and the general ed students are split into two different sections, which allows teachers and case carriers to follow the students more carefully. So let's go ahead and select the grade books we want to create. We want to create the two for period one, the period three, four, six, and eight. We're going to go to next. This is fall term. Make sure you pick the correct term. And now we're going to create grade books. You'll notice they're all created at once. The next step is to add and drop students. Anytime you see this red button on your Aeries dashboard, you know it's your signal to add or drop students. We can add them all at once by selecting all entering students, and we're going to add students. You will notice this is going to create an individual gradebook for each section you teach. So in Mrs. Garcia's case, she has two groups of students in period one. It's actually creating two sections. This is very important because you'll see in Canvas, she will also have two sections of students for period one. So here's all her grade books. We can now come over here. We can add categories. Now a shortcut for adding categories is to link your grade books together. We're going to do that right now, which means we're only going to have to add the categories one time. I'm going to hit save. And now when I select add categories, I'll do it one time. So the first one is going to be assignments. And the second one is assessments. And save. I strongly recommend not weighting categories, except in certain circumstances. It's better to weight assignments based on the points given to show which assignments are worth more than others. Assessments are worth more than a short homework assignment. Maybe a science lab is worth more than a reading assignment. You get the idea. You can, however, have as many categories you want, even without weighting. This is a good way to keep track of how well students are doing in assessments, mastering objectives, versus completing work in your class. All right, now that we have our categories set up, I'm going to go back to link gradebooks, and I need to unlink them. This is super important for Canvas. To sync grades accurately, without errors, gradebooks cannot be linked. If they are, you're going to end up getting duplicates. So now we have all of our grade books, and now it's time to move over to Canvas. So here I have Mrs. Garcia's seventh period math class. And we're going to go over to the assignments tab. You'll notice she already has quite a few assignments in here, which she copied in from last year. You'll notice she has three categories. Be careful, anytime you add assignments from a previous course or from another teacher, you'll get this imported assignments category. I'm looking, I see she has nothing in this group, so I'm going to go ahead and delete it for her. Okay. If you want more, you would just add plus group. So maybe you're a science teacher and you just want to keep track of labs. So you could add science labs for another category. This allows you to keep track of how students are doing in each of these categories. I'm going to go ahead and delete that. If you have any extra categories, you can delete them as well. Remember, in Canvas, your categories must match exactly, word for word, including capitals and spelling, the categories that you put in Aeries. This will ensure there are no errors when syncing. She does have weights here, so I do need to go back to Aeries and add those weights for her. Since math is a mastery subject, weights do make sense in this situation. Mastery subject, weights do make sense in this situation. The next thing you can do is verify that your sections in Canvas match your sections in Aeries. So I'm going to come down to the bottom and go to settings, my bottom of my course menu, and I'm going to select sections. And here I can see Mrs. Garcia has cross-listed her the three sections she teaches. And you'll notice this number here, 2023, that's the school year, 101, that's the school ID number, and 1075, that's the section number. So she has 1075, 1290, and 3157. When I switch back to Aeries and I go to her dashboard, I can then click on each of these sections and you're going to see that it matches for math. You have to go to Manage, Edit Gradebook. And notice one gradebook per section and there's the 1290. Now, Mrs. Garcia is ready to sync. When she's ready, she's going to go to the Grades tab. And she's going to select Sync, Sync to Aeries. I will show you one more thing real quick. You'll notice she's got unpublished assignments kind of polluting the gradebook. Pop over here to your settings, View Options, and deselect unpublished assignments. You also might want to add notes. Notes are a handy tool in the gradebook. Only you see them. Students don't see them. Remember, for grades to sync from Canvas to Aeries, at least one student must have a graded assignment for that particular assignment. Please like and subscribe and have a great school year.